Guys, if you haven't already, make sure to follow the podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. It helps us more than you could imagine.
Bro, I saw someone, and I hate to bring back, I feel like we talk about X all the time, yeah, but I have to bring back something, and it's all about Sports Day. How did you ever get on Sports Day?
Were you good at Sports Day? Just before we carry on about Sports Day, because I know we're going to talk about it for a little. I remember yesterday, I told you something, and you said you got ick from that, and it was about Shake Shack. We walked past Shake Shack in Stratford Westfield, and I told you about the time where I just moved to London. So I've just moved to London.
Oh my god, this story's unbelievable.
Picture the scene. I've just moved to London. Never been to London. Like, I've been to London once in my life. I've just moved here for YouTube. I'm living with Ali, Anis, and Gabe, Tobias. But those guys haven't moved in yet. They're moving in like 3 days. So I'm in my flat. I'm living life. I live right next to Westfield. I'm so happy. I go to Westfield to try out Shake Shack for the first time ever. We don't have it in the north. So I'm like, yeah. I go there. I've ordered my stuff. She goes, what's your name? I'm like, it's Josh. What's yours? I thought she was just feeling the crunch. She's just, all she wanted was the name for the order.
And you've gone, Josh, what's yours?
Bro, I haven't even realized till I've gone and sat down. She didn't say anything. She just replied back with her name and gave me a smile. I was like, yeah, like, I'm about. Like, I'm in my zone right now. Right, it is.
That is so funny.
I'm just a fucking Muppet. And I've sat down to myself and I thought, like, she's just asked another person for her name.
She's cheating on me already.
Like, why is she asking everyone their name?
Yeah, that is.
Says my name on the receipt.
Yeah.
That's a nick.
Oh man, you must have thought you were in as well.
I thought I was a goat. I had like that Ali confidence.
Unrelentless confidence.
I was built different than
All right,
anyway,
here we go.
Sports Day, you want to talk? Speak about
sorry, yeah, I did want to chat about Sports Day.
Yo, look at that, by the way.
Oh my god, your belly is wham.
I got a belly right now, too.
Yeah, bro. Get me in the gym. I went to the gym today.
How much would it cost you to lick my belly bum?
Not even that much, probably. You pay me like $250, I'd do it.
How much would it cost you to suck my toe?
Probably like $1,000.
I might have $1,000 lying about.
Yeah. It's Sports Day. Now, I want to talk about Sports Day, right? Because how did you do in Sports Day?
What kind of Sports Day? We're talking about the eggs.
School Sports Day.
I'm only good at like a few things.
Like, you know, you had it, people were, you know, put up for the 100 meter sprint, the 400 meter sprint. What did you do at Sports Day?
I was good at the endurance ones because I played basketball for all my things. So I would be able to even keep up with the best footballers in the school.
So what, like the long distance?
Even though
long,
I was possibly
distance.
One of the worst footballers in school, but long distance, no problem.
Really?
100 meters, no. I wasn't slow, but I wasn't fast.
You ever have your mum or dad come down?
Oh no, never. I'd rather die.
Really? No, but where the schools, the parents always came down.
Nah, I don't like that vibe.
And the one where like your dad would do like egg and spoon race.
Oh my god!
The parents.
What kind of sports day are we talking about here? We're talking about
sports
like a
day
high
when
school
you're a
one.
Kid, bro. Or primary school, whatever it
was. Oh, I thought you were talking about secondary school one. No, primary school for me, it was just like egg and spoon race, you know, like jumping in a sack.
Wheelbarrow,
all that kind of stuff.
Then the parents would give it a go?
Yeah, and they paired me up with some girl that's probably bigger than me in primary school. I'm like 30 kg. They're like, pick her up by the legs, Chip, wheelbarrow race. And I can't even pick her up.
This poor girl that has only been eating nuggets and chips her whole life with no veg.
That's why I thought we'd get on. You know, we've got a lot in common, nuggets
and
chips.
Oh my God, that's funny. No, the reason why I wanted to bring it up was just because I saw someone say that one of their biggest icks would have been like if they went down to watch Sports Day and then, you know, where they do the parents one and the dad's all racing, he comes like last. And then when he just has an absolute stinker in like the egg and spoon race or like the sprinting one and your man over there is just dead last. He's blowing at the back.
Oh no. Oh, he's tried though. We had a DM once about how a girl had a nick because she went to watch her boyfriend have a boxing fight and he got battered. But like you gotta respect anyone against the ring.
He got
though.
In there. I know, but it's one of
at the same time. It is like rough, like, you know.
It's crazy. Wait, didn't
Yeah, it was for charity as well.
Oh yeah, the boxing match was for a charity. Yeah. And then once she seen her man just get walloped, she was there like,
nah,
this just ain't busting no more.
This ain't it for me. He can't protect me.
Yeah. That's actually what it would have been. That's fucked. That is so deep as well. Your man did it for charity and you just sacked him off. That's so deep.
Absolute peak times. I tell you one. I got a funny story for you. When I was doing Waterloo Road extra work,
Yeah. Back in your prime
back
time.
Back in my prime. So there was a bunch of extras on this specific scene, and my job was to just come out into the hall from another room and walk down the room. But I couldn't hear the director. She was on the other side of the room. So she would always shout calls to like scene with extras. So I'll do it with the extras all doing their work. And sometimes it'll be like, just do the scene, extras all stay in your place. But I couldn't hear her properly because it's so far away. And so I thought she said, right, do the scene with the extras, should have a code word for it, whatever. And so I've gone walking out, walked down the hall, everyone's acting. And I don't see any of the extras about, and all the extras have just stood there looking at me as I'm walking doing my part, and I'm just like, oh no.
Oh.
I'm on camera. I think even everyone's looking at me like, what? Why is this kid just walking through the scene?
In the middle of the scene, you just got Chippo there rolling
doing
through.
Doing my thing. Yeah, I've got to even do a wave as well. Like, I'm just doing my wave, like, bang, yeah, this, all that kind of shit.
That, oh man, I love your Waterloo stories.
They're
so
good,
funny.
Man. They're good.
That's so good. Oh man.
Yeah.
I ain't got, that's the thing. You know what, that is on my bucket list, you know, to be an extra in a movie.
Really?
Or like in a TV series. Just appear like briefly on the screen and so, yo.
I know a girl that was a stormtrooper.
Yeah, that's probably because she dressed up like that to come around your gaff.
No. She told
madness.
Me, she was like, oh, I'm like doing acting. I was like, oh, really? What? She was like, yeah, just to Star Wars. I was like, what did you do? She was like, stormtrooper.
You fell in love, bro. I know you.
No, I swear to God.
No, obviously not. Like, obviously not. Chip obviously didn't fall in love with her. Did you ask to see a pic for proof?
No, I actually didn't, but like she isn't acting, so I just kind of believed her.
Yeah, fair enough. That's all right. Speaking.
No, but you are a star. You did links.
Yeah, I'm in like adverts, but no, I want to be in like a movie. Like I'm talking. Yeah, I want in the next Inception.
It would be sick to just like.
I'm just sitting behind Leonardo DiCaprio, just sipping on a little latte.
Did you ever watch where Casey Neistat was in a movie? Yes. I watched the movie. I can't remember what it was, but he's in it like, kind of like for a little bit.
I
like,
swear they say something to him, or he says something. He's got one line.
He's like a gangster in it or something. Honestly, I may be butchering this here, but I swear he's like a like some rich
Casey
weird
Neistat
guy.
Casey Neistat, gangster.
Nerve. No. Yes. With James Franco or the other Franco brother, right?
Fuck it.
But yeah, no. Have you ever seen that? Got that right. Dave Franco. That was it. Sorry. Yeah, Dave Franco. But yeah, no. That was interesting. He did all right, I thought. Logan Paul, Law and Order.
Logan Paul had his own movie called Airplane. It was absolutely fucking
really
dreadful.
I've not seen. I didn't know that
was it called Airplane. It was called Airplane Mode.
Was it shit?
Yeah, it's fucking awful.
Do you remember when we went to watch JJ and Casper's one?
Bro,
well?
Yo, people are gonna say that I'm just saying this because
it
was
bad.
But it wasn't that bad, bro. Considering the two main actors were YouTubers, I thought it was actually all right. Late in America, that was.
I thought the acting was okay, but like the story line was just
so
classic
shit.
And
so
the,
shit.
You know,
I actually went to the set of like there's a scene where they like there's like a dwarf in a castle. And like they've got this huge castle scene, and I went to that set. Like they were filming there for like a week, and I went to it because I was out in LA anyways. We all had a big house there while they were filming that movie.
Yeah.
And yeah, I went to it, bro, and I was like, "This is sick, bro!" Like the whole experience. I know JJ would have liked it as well.
I got a sick one for you here.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you reckon Lady in America's Rotten Tomatoes score is? We'll get Alex to check it.
Bro, I reckon it's high. Do you know what? Anything more than 30%, and I swear to God, right,
I've got
it
one for you, okay?
Yeah.
Loser?
Yeah.
Okay, there's a shot of Sambuca.
All right.
We have to guess Lady in America's Rotten Tomatoes score.
Okay, I reckon it got 30 on the dot.
I'm going to go somewhere close. Yeah. I'm going to say 30, like... Oh, I might say 40.
No.
I'll say 40. I'll say 40.
Cool.
Alex, what is it?
Made in America.
Bro, by the way, these kind of films sometimes get like 10 and 10.
No, I've seen one with like 2 and 3. 2 and 3%.
Yeah, I've seen a couple of 2 and 3. I've gone so high here. I don't know, you know.
Because Rotten Tomatoes is one of the harshest critics of movies. So they don't actually have...
audience score might be like inflated
because it would just would have been fans
score?
The audience score is 57, which is really good. Well, it's no audience score tends to be
I've won this, haven't I?
But here, okay, but another thing that could sway in my favor is there wasn't enough movie critics to give a proper Rotten Tomato score, but there was one.
And one critic?
One critic, okay? And his name is Jason Best. And Jason Best has given it, well, first of all, he's described it as crass and witless.
Fucking best little wanker, more like.
Fucking Jason.
Jason Bourne over it.
Yeah, cheers. That was class.
Jesus Christ, it's Jason Bourne.
He's given it 20%.
I reckon we just both do a shot.
Yeah, fuck it. Come on then.